Hello, welcome to TS Classes. In this video, we will study about Routh-Hurwitz stratability criteria. Okay, let's start our class. Routh-Hurwitz criteria. It is the fast process to find the stability of a control system. Here, it may follow some following steps. First step is we have to find out what is the characteristic equation of the transfer function. The first point is to find out the characteristic equation of the control system. Next, in this characteristic equation, we have to arrange it in a descending order of power of s. Okay, the second point is arrange that in decreasing order of the power of s. By taking an example, we will see that let the characteristic equation is q of s is equal to a0 s to the power n plus a1 s to the power n minus 1 plus a2 s to the power n minus 2 plus similarly a0 s to the power of 0. It means here in this characteristic equation, the power of s is from n, n minus 1, n minus 2, and it is gradually decreases, and the last point is s to the power 0. So this is the characteristic equation. First point was to find the characteristic equation, we have already found it out, and the second point is arrange that in the decreasing order of the power of s. It is already arranged. Next we have to go, what is the next step? Next step is we have to arrange this in a tabulation method. That means we have to arrange this characteristic equation by here. First is s power of n we have to write. It means if the maximum power is n here, then the first line I have to write s power n, second line s power n minus 1, third line s power n minus 2. Similar to we have to write the last line is s power of 0. Okay, now in this table, in this tabular method, we have to fill this first two rows by this characteristic equation. It means in the first line is filled by if the power of s is n, n is the maximum, then the coefficient of n, s to the power n, that is a0, is written here. If a, n is odd, then all the power of odd power will be written in the first line. If n is even, then all the even power will be written in the first line. So here s to the power n, the coefficient is a0. By skipping the first second line, then the third point is a2. So I have to write a2 is here. Similarly, third is a4, and similarly go on. Next, the third, so second row. In the second row, the points which we have already skipped, I have to write here. It means a0 is written here, a1 is not written. So I will write a1 is here. Similarly, after a1, a2 is written here. So a3 will be here. Now a4 was in the first line, so here it will be a5. Clear? First two line will be filled by this characteristic equation, and the s power n coefficient, and the by skipping the 1 1 value, all the line will be written in the first row. In the second row, all the skips point will be written here. Now we have to go for the third, fourth, similar to the last line. What we'll have to do in the third row, we have to write here, suppose it is c1, sorry, it is b1, b2, b3, and all the things will be written here. What will be the value of b1? What we will write in place of b1? We have to follow a formula, that is b1 is equal to, if we write in the value of b1, then the upper value of b1 is equal to a1. So a1 into, it will be cross multiplied with a2. So b1 is equal to a1 into a2 minus its opposite sides, a0 into a3 minus a0 into a3 divided by its upper value, what is a1. So the value of b1 we will find out by this formula. Similarly, the value of b2, the value of b2 will be in the same manner, b2 will be written by the first column points with respect to the second column points. we will cross multiply both of these two. Taking place, B2 is equal to A1 into A4 minus A0 into A5 divided by that one, A1. Similarly, B3, we have to cross multiply the first column with respect to the next column. What will the element will be here? That will be cross multiplied and divided by the A1. So this third row will be filled by this equation. Similarly, in the next, that is S minus 3, S to the power N minus 3, if it is written as C1, C2, C3 and so on, what will the value of here? The value of C1 will be, I have to write its upper one, that is A1, B1 and the next. So we have to cross multiply this. That implies in place of C1, I have to write B1 into A3, that is B1 into A3 minus A1 into B2, A1 into B2 whole divided by this B1. Similarly, for B2, the value will be A1, B2 and B3, A5, B3. These two will be cross multiplied. That means B1, A5 minus A1, C3 divided by B1. In this process, we have to follow all the points till the power of S0. Suppose the S0 turn, the value will be Z1, Z2, Z3 and similarly. After doing all the table, we will find whether it is stable or not. It has some extra points, but first the main point is that we have to find it that all the element from the first column, which I have already got, that is A0, A1, B1, C1, here whatever may be the value D1, D2 till the last value Z1. If all the elements are positive, then the system will be stable. If any one of the point is negative, the system will be unstable. The main point is whether it is stable or not. It is, if all are positive, then it is stable. If any one of these is negative, then it is unstable. If any one value from this column is zero, then it has also another method. We will study all the things in the next class onwards, whether the value is zero. It has also two conditions. If one value is zero, if the total row is zero, it has also another formula. So we will study all the things one by one. Today in this class, we have studied about in this Rao-Thurwitz criteria. In this criteria, we have to arrange all these things in a particular RA method, means in the decreasing order of S to the power N. It is also known as a RA. So this method is known as Routh RA criterion. In the next class, we will study with an example all the things, whatever the conditions are there and whether it is stable, unstable, and if the value is zero, what will you have to do. In the next class, we will do all the things with a particular example. Thank you.